कृतारिवञ्चने दृष्टिः येनाञ्जनमधीमसाम् अच्युताय नमस्तस्मै परमौचित्यकारिणे. वि वर् लुकिङ्ग् एट् वाक्यगतम् औचित्यं वेर् हि एक्स्प्लेन्ड् अबौट् दुर्योधन सोरि भीमास् स्टेट्मेण्ट् देवो दयावान् एण्ड् देन् वि आल्सो सा अबौट् another example also he gave sambandhi purubhujam where he talked about shringara rasa uddipanam and how the auchityam works there also. Now he is giving us an example of anauchityam, just as always the counter example also. So nale shaurya mahot na tu yatha asyaiva asyaiva works only Rajashekara. Rajashekara has given the same given another shloka, which is an example for vakyagatam anauchityam. Nale shaurya mahotpalasya vipule setau samidvaridehe shashvat khadga bhujanga chandana tarau kridopadane shriyaha alane jayakunjarasya sudrisham kandarpadarpe param shri duryodhana doshni vikramapare leenam jagat nandatu. Shri Duryodhana Doshni Vikramapare Doshni. In the shoulders of Duryodhana, which is extremely valorous, no? Vikramapare Jagat Leenam Jagat Nandatu. Let the world that is, you know, resting on Duryodhana's shoulder, Nandatu, let it be happy. Nandatu. Leenam Jagat, resting on his shoulders in the sense, because of Duryodhana's parakrama, he protects the entire world with his bhuja, with his arms. Right? So, Leenam Jagat, it's as if the world is just lying down or it is just resting against his shoulder, and let it be happy. Nandatu. Now, how is that Doshni? Everything is... in Saptami Vibhakti as an adjective to Duryodhana. He uses metaphor to describe how it is. Now, this Duryodhana's arm is like a support for Shauryam, for his valor, okay, for his courage. How does he say that? Shaurya mahotpalasya nale doshni. Everything is an adjective to doshni. So, Shaurya mahotpalasya. If you look at the pond and a lily flower, that Utpala flower, how it is it is a big Utpala flower, but it is being supported by a very thin strand or a stem. That is called a nala. So even the lotus stalk, if you see, its stalk is extremely thin, and you won't even, from a distance, you won't even be able to identify the stalk because the flower will be so big and huge and heavier than the stalk. Now, how can it hold that? Here, Shaurya, in the same way, he talks of Duryodhana's bhuja as that nala or the lotus stalk, which has the capability of holding something such a huge kamalam. So, shaurya mahotpalasya. Here, the kamalam, the metaphor is used to describe the courage. So, his bhuja is like the, his bahu is like the support for shauryam, which is like a great lily flower. Next, samidvaridehe. Vipule setau. So his arms are like the wide bridge for the ocean. Just like how the ocean has a bridge as a support or as a thing to cross it. If there is a bridge on an ocean, then you can cross it. Here, if you have to cross the ocean of battles, then you need the power of his arms. So samit is yuddham. Yuddha varidehe setu yatha asti varidhim param gantum varidehe param gantum setuhu yatha vartate tatha asya bhujau api setu rupena. So here he imagines that his arms are like the bridge that we use to cross the battlefield, which is like an ocean. Next is shashvat khadga bhujanga chandana tarau. Khadga bhujanga chandana tarav. his arms are like that chandana tree, where for the smell of the chandanam, apparently all snakes will go and reside in a chandana tree. That is very commonly found in kavyas. So Bhujanga here, his arm is like the chandana tree, the sandalwood tree, and the khadgam or his sword is like the Bhujanga, like the serpent which is there on the chandanam tree. So Shashwat khadga, Shashwat, it is always present. Nitya Yuktam. So the khadgam, the sword that is always present, it is like the serpent for the chandana tree, that is his bhujam, which is like the chandana tree. Next is Shriyaha Krida Upadhane. Rajya Lakshmi's, it is like the Rajya Lakshmi's pillow. She needs the pillow, right? So Krida Upadhanam and the Bahu Upadhanam Madri. Sita will look for something to rest on in Uttaramacharitam. She'll say, I want to rest, I want to sleep, let me look for a pillow. So Rama will say, Bahu Padhanam, which has always been your pillow, use that. And he will offer his Bahu, his arms for her, for Sita. So Krida Upadhane Shriyaha, for Lakshmi, his Bhuja, it is like the Upadhana or the pillow, which he sportingly uses. So she, which means the Rajalakshmi rests on his hands. It does not need anybody else's support. Jaya Kunjarasya Alanam. Jaya, victory. Victory is like an elephant. And to control that victory, there is an Alana Stambha. Alanam indicates both the Stambha and the Shrinkhala. Stambha is a column where the elephant is being tied. Or Shrinkhala, it is also being tied with a chain. So in order to control victory, he has he is like the chain which pulls in or which controls the jaya or victory. It is in his hands, right? Just like how an elephant is being controlled by the or tied to that Alana Stambha with a Shrinkhala, here that victory is tied to him with his arms. He gets the victory because of his Bhujabala. Sudrisham. Whereas for beautiful ladies, Sushtu Drik Yeshamte. So whoever has beautiful eyes, so the ladies, for the ladies, Param Kandarpa Darpe. It is like the arrogance of Manmatha has taken the form of Duryodhana's arm. So biceps, no? The moment you look at biceps, you feel very attracted towards it. So he's talking about that. Sudrisham, for beautiful ladies, his arm is like the arrogance of Manmatha. Tadrishe doshni, vikramapare doshni, vikramapare bhuje, jlinam jagat, ashritam jagat, nandatu, let it be happy. Huh? Here, now what is the problem? It seems like a beautiful description, but our only problem is that nale shaurya mahopale. The moment you say nala, you use the word nala or the kamala dandam, mrinala. For what do you use it for? You use it for a lady's beautiful sharira or something which is weak. It indicates something which is weak. Even though Rajashekara is trying to stress on the fact, Maha Utpala, he uses the word Maha Utpala there. Just to show that a Nala has the capability of holding up a huge lotus. But still, the moment you say Nale, and you start off the shloka with Nale, what are you talking about? Are you talking about some sharire, something which is weak, something which is beautiful? No, he is actually talking about Vikrama Pare Duryodhana Doshni. And where does the Vikrama come from, the word Nala? So the entire Vakyartha becomes a problem because of Nale and Shaurya Mahotpale. Shaurya is described as something soft. Even that will not work here. Okay. So that is the Anauchityam that we have. Nala Dandaha. Would Nala Danda work? Chhatra Dande. It won't work because
it, Even if you were to take danda or nala in general, it represents something very slender, right?
Yes.
So somehow, I mean, when you started itself, that first line itself, it was like, oh, this doesn't seem right. But I didn't know if I would, you know, be able to guess. But when you read the entire thing, it felt, okay, this nala thing is not working.
Good, you're on track. That's what now you understand what is Auchitya and what is Anauchitya. See, some things will just be so apparent. Certain things only the Vyakheta has to point it out to us to understand. Oh, okay. Now that is where the Anauchityam lies. Right? In Tanvyaha Tanum Tanvate, we may not have even recognized that point until the author pointed out. Right? In the first one. So this is very apparent. Even if it is Nala, instead of Nala, Danda and the Utpala itself does not go. See, Shauryam and Utpalam itself do not connect properly. That's why. Okay. So, Atra, Atishaya Para, Karkasha, Sotkarsha, Subhata, Bhuja, Stambasya. He is trying to bring out the Vikrama or the Virarasam that Duryodhana will evoke. Whereas that Virarasa is not coming out properly when you start off with Naladanda. So, Atishaya Para, Atishaya Rupena, Para, Karkasha, Para, Shatrubhyaha, Karkasha, Sotkarsha. So everything is an adjective to the Bhujaha. So Bhujastambaha. So Karkashaha, Bhujastambaha. Subhata, Sotkarshaha, Bhujastambaha. Subhata, Bhujastambaha. So Subhata is Duryodhana. So he is a great warrior, and such a great warrior like Duryodhana, whose Bhujastambha is being described here, cannot be shown with a softness, a komalatvam. So asamuchitena, it's not appropriate. Asamuchitena, kuvalaya nala tula adhiropanena, by the superimposition of the nala or the lotus stalk or the lily stalk. Here there is an asamuchitam. It is not appropriate because of that factor. What has happened? Vakyartaha sopahasataya iva nibaddaha. It is as if he has used it to ridicule Duryodhana. Now would that be, that is where I got confused a little bit, but we will take it as na uchitam, because no matter what, he is a veera. He is a Subhata, a very good warrior. So you have to give the devil its due, and you have to give him that importance that he needs. So you cannot make his Shauryam as an Utpala, like a Komala Kusuma Iva. You can't have that here, right? So, Sobahasataya Iva Nibaddaha Parijnayate. It seems as if he has done the shloka in order to ridicule Duryodhana and his parakrama. Because of that incongruent adjective, he is actually ridiculing Duryodhana. Then maybe it is uchitam. I don't know the context of the whole kavyam, then it may not fit. But here, if you say the jagat leenam jagat nandatu, if you want the jagat to be very happy in his arms, then you can't say nale. For that meaning is not appropriate. As a prabandhartha, as the entire kavyam is taken and you want to ridicule Duryodhana, you can't constantly keep ridiculing him. You have to give him his due and talk about his parakrama in a great manner, and then say, okay, Arjuna has fought over, won over him, or Bhima killed him. Then it will make more sense. If you start off with the fact that he is very weak, then there is no prayojanam for Bhima's veera varnana there. Okay, so Vakyagatam, Anauchityam is done. Next, he talks about Prabandartha. Prabandartha Auchityam Darshayitum Aha, Uchitartha Visheshena Prabandartha Prakashate, Gunaprabhava Bhavyena Vibhavena Iva Sajjanaha. Gunaprabhava Bhavyena Vibhavena Iva Sajjanaha. Now, Prabandartha is the subject matter of a treatise, of a composition. It can be anything. It can be the entire subject matter of the whole kavyam itself, or it can be just one small aspect that he is trying to introduce at that point, which will connect the entire text for us. Like, for example, the Shapa in Shakuntalam is a Prabandhartha which connects the Vismaranam of, that is the way Dushyanta forgets Shakuntala and the way Shakuntala ends up in someone else's ashramam, and it later causes them to come together. Right? So that is one Prabandhartha. So Prabandhartha need not be the subject matter of the entire Kavyam. It can also be small incidents that are being treated in that treatise or in that composition. So uchita artha visheshena, by an appropriate usage of artha, the prabandhartha prakashate, the prabandhartha, it lends a beauty to the entire text because of that one small aspect. If you look at Raghuvamsha, soham ajanma shuddhanam aphalodaya karmanam, Raghuvamsha, he wants to describe about how his effort, manda kavyashav prarthi, he's trying to say, my effort is nothing. What I'm trying to do is just sutre manigana iva. Everything else is somewhere, you know, people have described each raja in their own works, but they have all not been combined together in one work. And so he starts off by saying, so hamajanma shuddhanam aphalodaya karma raghunam anvayam vakshye. Raghunam, I want to talk about the Raghu Vamsha because they are so great. And he enumerates the qualities of them. The same way in Ramayana also, he talks of konvasmin sampratam loke ko viryavan kascha dhairyavan and all that gunavan ka virya kascha viryavan. Ko gunavan kascha viryavan, and he lists, enumerates, Valmiki enumerates a list of qualities for Rama. And then, so if you look at the Ramayanam, each and every quality will fit with one of the incidents in the Ramayanam as such. Ko viryavan, he will show his virya. Ko gunavan, he will show his guna elsewhere. Saundaryam, kantiman, he will show his prakasha at one point. So it will fit beautifully. That is the artha vishesham that it highlights. Okay, or it can be a small incident also. It will embellish that. If you look at the example, you'll understand further. So guna prabhava bhavyena vibhavena iva sajjanaha. Sajjanaha vibhavena yatha prakashate vibhavaha aishwaryena. Aishwaryena yatha prakashate, but that aishwarya should have guna prabhava bhavyena. Gunang, he should have a lot of good dakshinyadi guna. Daya, dakshinya, if he does not have daya, there is no point in having wealth, and he just distributes wealth without any daya, then there is no point in that. It embellishes the gunas that he has, embellishes the wealth that a sajjana, a good person has. The same way, any small one or two shlokas can immediately provide a huge, you know, different color to the entire prabandha. That is called Prabandhartha Auchityam. The example that he takes is from Kalidasa's Megha Sandesha. Jatam Vamshe Bhuvana Vidite Pushkaravartakanam Janamitvam Prakriti Purusham Kamarupam Maghonaha Tenarthitvam Vidhi Paravashat Durabandhur Gatoham Yachnya Moha Varamadhigune Nadhame Labdha Kama. The nya and the cha are different. It should be yach nya. The cha should be before. Yach nya mogha varam adhigune nadhame labdha kama. Here the megha, he describes the megham. First, before this shloka, he will say, Dhumat Jyotis Salila Marutam Sannipata Kwamegaha, because you need that why this thing is coming up. First of all, he has a doubt as to whether he can send a message through a megha, through a cloud, to his wife. So you are an achetana, and the messages have to be sent through Chetana Vastu, who are conscious, through men or women or people who are conscious and who should be experts in transmitting those messages. But still, I am sending through you. Now, you can't start off your conversation like this, right? How can you then how you whereas he will start off the conversation with Jatam Vamshe Bhuvanavidite Pushkaravartakanam. He has to say what a great ancestry this Megha has. This is Pushkara Avartakanam Bhuvana Vidite Pushkara Avartakanam Vamshe Jatam Tvam Aham Yache. I know that you have been born in such a great, you have a great ancestry in such a big kulam. What is that kulam? Pushkara and Avartaka are the names of Meghas which are during the Pralayakala, which come during the Pralayakala. So Tathavidha Pushkara Avartakanam Bhuvanavidite Vamshe, very famous in the entire world, Vamshe, in that family you have been born. Jatam, you have been born in the family which is extremely famous in the entire world. And whose family is that? Pushkara and Avartaka. These are the Meghas during the dissolution or the Pralaya. That is one aspect. Next is, what is it? Okay, one is Pushkara and Avartaka, your Vamsha. What about the person who is born in that Vamsha? You, that Megha. You are, I know, Maghonaha Prakriti Purusham Kamarupam Cha Janami. I know that you are Indra's right hand. Prakriti Purushaha, you help him in every manner. Pradhana Purushaha. Prakriti Purusha is, Prakriti is also Amatya. Megha is supposed to be like the Amatya or the minister for Indra. So Maghonaha Amatyaha. So Prakriti Purusham Maghonaha Tvam Janami. And I also know Kamarupam. You, Kamarupa is Ishtarupam. You can take whatever form you want and you can come in appear in front of people. So if I want you to appear as a small person so that you don't make my wife afraid, you can do that also. You're well capable of that. So Jatam Vamshe Bhuvana Vidite, you have to praise the person in front of you so that they will do a favor to you. I know very well that you have been born in such a great family. You are also the like the prime minister of Maghona. Maghonaha, Maghavan is the Prathama Vibhakti there. Maghonaha is Shashti Vibhakti. So Maghonaha Prakriti Purusham Kamarupam Cha Tvam Janami. I know you as that. Sutena Tasmat Karanat Aham Arthitvam Gataha. I have been put in a position to ask you. That is why I have come in front of you to ask a favor of you. What is that? Aham, the visheshana for aham is vidhi paravashat durabandhur katoha. Vidhi paravashat. What is that? Vidhi paravasham kaschit kanta viraha guruna sadhikarat pramattaha shapena astangamita mahima varshabhogyena bhartuhu. I have been cursed by Kubera to be in this forest for at least 1 year. So vidhi paravashat, it is because of fate that I'm here. It's not because of anything else. So I am, even though you are of such a great family, you have to accept my request. Even though I am, because it is only out of fate that I am suffering here and I have to ask you. I should not be Magonaha Prakriti Purusham. Can you even appoint a minister as a Duta? You cannot. But why does he do that? He will explain to you at the last shloka where he says in the Arthantra Nyasa. So let's come here. Vidhi Paravashat, because I am dependent on Vidhi, Dura Bandhu, my wife is somewhere else, she is far away, Tadrishaha Aham Arthitvam Gataha Arthi Rupena Atrasthitaha. And what does he do? He justifies his statement. Prakriti Purusham Duta Rupena Katham. He wants to justify that point and he says, Yajnya Mogha Varam Katkutra Adhi Gune. Tamil, Kuttu Pattalu Modra Gayala Kuttu Pattnomba. Even if you get hit, you have to get hit with someone who is wearing a diamond ring. Which means you go ask someone and they reject ask someone with value and they reject, then it's okay. You go ask a king, you go ask a rich man for something, some favor, and he doesn't do it, it's okay. You go ask a poor man, he won't even have something to do for himself. That is the idea that he's trying to give here. So adhi gune, not just for riches, he's saying adhi gune for a person who has a lot of good qualities. Adhi gune mogha yancha, even if my request goes unfulfilled. Mogha nishphala prarthana varam, it is much better than adhame labdha kama. If it is a nicha person and my manoratha is getting satisfied, I don't wish that. I am okay to get rejected by a great person rather than getting my desire satisfied by someone who is not worth it. Adhame kshudra manushye labdha kama purta manoratha, purita manoratha. If my desires are satisfied, I am not willing to do that. I don't want my desires to be satisfied by any means. I would rather go and ask someone who is great and get rejected. I am fine with that. Adigune mogha yachnya varam natu adhame yachnya labdha kama api na varam. It is not good. What is the point here? He is trying to say the entire prabandha lies on the fact that he is of such a great ancestry. The megha being a achetana vastu, a vastu which is doesn't have any consciousness, even though he is like that, he attributes so many chetanatvam to it. He superimposes chetanatva on the megha, which is the bijam for the entire prabandha, which gives an a propriety, an auchityam for the entire prabandha, and it rests on these two shlokas. One is the state of the yaksha himself, where he says kamartha hi prakriti krapanaha chetana chetaneshu, where I am suffering from love and so I do not know the difference between chetana and achetana, hence I am approaching a megha and asking, can you be my messenger? The other thing is the very fact that he is approaching a megha, why is it okay, and how can the entire text be written based on that, is because of the shloka. So this is the shloka that contributes or justifies the entire text as such. Jatam Vamshe, he is of such an ancestry and with so many good qualities, he is in fact in the position of a prime minister, and yet I am asking. The reason for asking is yachnya mogha varamadhigune nadhame labdha kama. Atra अचेतनस्य, दिस् द वृत्ति हियर, अचेतनस्य चेतन अध्यारोपेण, चेतनत्व अध्यारोपेण, हि सुपर इम्पोसेस चेतनत्वम और चेतन द एक्शंस ऑफ एनी चेतन वस्तु, एनी पुरुष हू कैन एक्ट एज अ दौत्य योग्यता. सो द द प्रोप्रायटी और द हि बिकम्स फिट टू बी अ मेसेंजर बिकॉज on an achetana vastu he is superimposing chetana vastu qualities. Chetana adhyaropena meghasya dautya yogyata adhanaya, in order to give a fitness for, you know, the a propriety of, or how do I say that, to say that the megha is fit to be a duta. Dutasya bhavaha dutasya karma dautya pratita pushkara avartaka parjanya vamshyatvam. He is in that vamshyatvam. He is a vamshyaha, vamshe bhavaha vamshyaha. So he is in that ancestry, in that kulam of Pushkara and Avartaka. Pratita, famous kula of Pushkara and Avartaka. Parjanya is a megha. So he is in that megha kulam of Pushkara and Avartaka. The other one is amatya prakriti purushatvancha. He is also the Amatya or Prakriti Purushatvam, in the sense he is the Pradana Purusha of Indra. That quality is also being Upanyastam. It is being placed forward for the readers. తేన బికాస్ ఆఫ్ దట్ రీజన్ సమస్త ప్రబంధస్య ది ఎంటైర్ టెక్స్ట్ వాట్ హ్యాపెన్స్ ఉత్ప్రేక్షిత ఇతి వృత్త రుచిరతరస్య దేర్ ఇస్ అ టైపో ఇన్ ద టెక్స్ట్ ఇట్ ఇస్ రుచిరతరస్య నిరతిశయం ఔచిత్యం ఉద్యోతితం. We understand a great fitness or appropriateness here, auchityam here, because we are able to utprekshita iti vritta ruchirasya. This is how it happened. You know, the entire text, the story, iti vrittam is the story. The imagined story of a megha traveling through Bharatavarsha, going to Alakapuri and delivering the message. The entire story, samasta prabandasya utprekshitasya, ఇతివృత్త రుచిర తరస్య ఇట్ ఇస్ రెండర్డ్ మచ్ మోర్ బ్యూటిఫుల్ అండ్ ఎంజాయబుల్ బికాస్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ ఔచిత్యం అండ్ అ గ్రేట్ ఫిట్నెస్ షోన్ బికాస్ హీ హెస్ పుట్ ఫోర్త్ దీస్ టూ థింగ్స్ చేతనత్వ అధ్యారోపం బికాస్ ఆఫ్ ద చేతనత్వ అధ్యారోపం ద మేఘ బికమ్స్ ఫిట్ టు బీ అ మెసెంజర్ టూ త్రీ అండ్ హీ ఇస్ ఇన్ఫాక్ట్ talking of adigunam, he is talking of the great quality of the megha by saying he is from a great kulam, megha kula, and he is also like the amatya or the prime minister for maghonaha, for maghavan, for indra. Because of these things, the entire prabandha's imaginative story gets an propriety because of this. Okay, అత్ర అచేతనస్య చేతనత్వ చేతన అధ్యారోపేణ మేఘస్య దౌత్య యోగ్యత ఆధానాయ ప్రతిత పుష్కర ఆవర్తక పర్జన్య వంశ్యత్వం అమాత్య ప్రకృతి పురుషత్వం చ ఉపన్యస్తం తేన సమస్త ప్రబంధస్య ఉత్ప్రేక్షిత ఇతి వృత్త రుచిరతరస్య నిరతిశయం ఔచిత్యం ఉద్యోతితం. నెక్స్ట్ ఇస్ ఫ్రమ్ ఉత్తరాచరితం. దిస్ ఇస్ నాట్ ఫర్ ది entire text or anything, it just highlights the veera rasa that is there at that point of time to give a different color in the prabandha. This is not there in the material. It is another example for prabandha auchityam. Yathava bhavabhutehe, this is in act 5 or end of 4, end of 4, sorry, yeah, it is in the end of act 4 where Rama's soldiers are all bringing the Ashwamedha Yaga Ashwa, and they are bringing it from the, before they bring it, you never usually show all that on the stage. So there is a shout from the Nepathye, from behind the screen, there is a Veera Ghoshana, an announcement is being made where he says, Yoyam Ashwaf Patakeyam, Athava Veera Ghoshana, Saptaloka Yeka Veerasya Dashaganta Kuradvishaha. We have this Ashwa, this horse is here. Yaha ayam Ashwaha. There is this horse that is here. Iyam patakava. This pataka, that is the flag that we are carrying. Or athava iyam veeragoshana. Or this announcement of bravery. What is this? Whose is this? Saptaloka yeka veerasya. The only warrior for the, all seven worlds. This saptaloka yeka veerasya. And Dashakantha Kula Dvishaha. He is the enemy of Dashakantha Kula. Dashakantha, Ravana's entire Kula, entire family. He is an enemy to the entire family. So he has destroyed the whole family. Tathavidaha Ramaha. So the Veera Rasam of Rama has been established here. Okay, that is one aspect. The next part is, as soon as Lava hears this Veera Ghoshana, Lava does not know that he is Rama's son. He looks at this Ashwa. This is not present in Ramayana also. That is what Kshemendra says. It is beyond Ramayana. Maybe there is just one portion where he stops it and he tries to, you know, he stops the Ashwa, he just ties it up and people come and try to talk reason, and then Rama comes, he recognizes, and it's a very smooth transition in Ramayana. Whereas in Rama, there is also another aspect that maybe during Kshemendra time, the Uttara Kandam did not exist. Ramayana ended with the Yuddha Kandam, and Uttarakanda, there is an idea in the history that Uttarakanda is a later interpolation. And it never existed in Ramayana before. And Ramayana ended with the Yuddha Kanda. That is the popular with the Pattabhishekam, and it just ended with that. So here he is probably of that tradition where he says this never existed in Ramayana. Now what happens? Lava, as soon as he hears this Veera Ghoshana, any warrior who hears this, Saptaloka Eka Veerasya, there is only one warrior in this entire world. Lava being a Kshatriya boy, he is only 12 years old here. Sa Garvamiva, as if with an Ahankara, Aho Sandeepanani Aksharani. It says Santapanani. More than this, I think there is another reading where it says Sandeepanani Aksharani. These words are kindling the sentiment in me. Bho Bho Kim Akshatriya Prithivi Yadevam Udghoshyate. Is this world without any Akshatriya, without any Kshatriyas? Are there no Kshatriya that you are saying that Rama is the Ekaika Saptaloka Ekavirasya Dashakantakula Dvishasya? Only the enemy of Dashakantakula, Ravana's Kula, is the only warrior in this entire world. How can you say such a thing? Is this world Akshatriya? Yet Yevam, because of that reason you are making such an announcement in this world. Then he Vihasya. Aha. Kim nama spuranti shastrani. The dhanu, the bow that is there in my arms and in my hand, and the shastram, the weapons that I have, spuranti, they are as if they are just prakashante. This is the shloka that he says, let my bow be like the mouth of Yama, which can take the lives of all the people in the battlefield. So jya jihvaya valayitotkata koti damshtra udgari ghosha ghana ghargara ghoshametat grasa prasakta hasat antaka vaktra yantra jrimbha vitambi vikatodaram astu chapam. Chapam etat chapam vikata udaram astu antaka vaktra vikata udaram astu. Let this chapa, let my bow be like antaka udaram, antaka vaktra udaram. Let it be like the interior of antaka, Yama's mouth. Now how, when you have to tie the bow, you take the string from the lower portion and tie it. As they tie it, they have to actually bend it in such a manner that the bow won't be straight like this and straight like this. It will actually be more of an oval shape or a curve, like a mouth opening. So jya jikhvaya, with the thread jikhva, that string of that bow is like the tongue that is there in Yama's mouth. So jya jikhvaya, jya is the bow string, which is like the tongue. Jya jikhvaya valayita, it has been tied. Utkata koti damshtram, the chapam has a damshtra in the corner. The corners are so sharp that it looks like it has teeth. Imagine it is like the mouth of Yama. So the corners are like teeth, and the jya bowstring is like the tongue. And then there is a sound that is coming out of the mouth when you are making a veera sound. And the bow also, when you pull the string, there is a sound that comes out of the mouth, which is udgari. It is like the yawning sound. Ghosha, ghana, ghar, ghara, ghosham. The ghargara sound of ghana, megha. The chapa has that sound also. The bow has that sound. Etat chapam. How does it look like? Let it be grasa prasakta hasat antaka. Hasat antaka. Antaka, who is laughing. Yama, who is laughing. And why is he laughing? Grasa prasakta. He wants to grab the grasa, mamsam. He wants to grab kavalam, not mamsa. It's more the lives of people. He is very involved in grasping everything. Because of that, he is hasat. Antaka vaktra yantra. His mouth is the yantram. It is like a machine which is just pulling things inside it. Jrimbha, he is opening his mouth. Vidambi, it is resembling the antaka vaktra yantra jrimbha. My bow is like that Yama's mouth. And it is vikata udaram. It is showing its udara, its interior portion. So if you look at someone who has opened their mouth so much, you will even see that small tongue uvula that is, you know, there inside. So you have to imagine the bow like that. So the bow is like Yama's mouth. These words are actually showing off his prowess. A 12-year-old is looking at an entire army which is following Rama's Ashwa and Pataka, the flag, and the Veerabhoshana, the announcement. So he is expressing that Chauryam contributes to how Lava is very much like Rama when in the matters of Veeram, to let people know his Veeram. So Atra Arthe Ramayana Katha Atikramena, it is beyond the Ramayana Katha. So we will assume that Ramayana ends with Yuddha Kanda. And all of these things are only Utprekshita. That is, you have, it is the fancy of the poet. Nutana Utprekshita, it is a new angle that you have given. Even though you can, even if you think of the Uttarakandam, you won't have all these details there probably. So by Lava's shloka, we understand the shauryam of Lava also, and the veera, the courage that Lava has, which is the same that Rama also had, by way of indicating how Lava is non-different from Rama and it is easy for Rama to recognize him. In that way, the Uttarama Charita, the drama, it becomes supportive to the drama. Where is it? Yeah. Anutana Utprekshita Rama Tanayasya Lavasya Sahaja Vikrama Anusarini. It's a very natural Vikrama, the prowess he was showing. Anusarini, that which follows that Vikrama, his show of prowess. Shaurya Utkarsha Bhumihi, it excels in Shaurya or Parakrama. So Shaurya Utkarsha Bhumihi Parapratapa Sparsha Ashahishmata. Parapratapa Sparsha, not even a touch of another person's greatness he can tolerate. That Asahishnuta, he is unable to tolerate the greatness of another person. That is the self-pride that he has in his parakrama. Sparsha Asahishnuta Prabandhasya, for the entire text, Rasa Bandhuram, it adds a beauty to the rasa. Rasa bandhura means the enjoyability. Aswadanatam auchitya chayam prayachati. Auchitya chaya means it is the shade of auchitya. It is not just a little bit auchitya. You also use auchitya by saying, you know, dhavada chaya asti. It is a little bit white. It is a little bit black. He is not using it in that term. He is talking of how, you know, a tree provides a shade to the entire world that is there, or how Adishesha provides shade to the entire world. You have to imagine it like that. And here, Auchitya Chaya, in the sense, he gives the shadow of Auchitya for the entire text because of showing Lava's prowess here. So it has an effect in the entire work. That is your Prabandhartha Auchityam. Next is Prabandhartha Gatam Anauchityam. The example that is gives, again he takes up Rajashekara and he says, Ravana, this is the scene where Ravana approaches the Sita Swayamvara, and there, this is Ravana's shloka, entrance shloka, where he says, bring the Shivadhanus. He says, Yat Parvati Hatakacha Grahana Praveene Panaustitam Purabhidaha Sharadam Sahasram Girvana Sarakana Nirmita Gatram Atra Tan Maithili Krayadhanam Dhanuravirastu. Atra, at this point in Janaka Sabha, Maithili Krayadhanam Dhanuhu, you know, the Dhanus, the bow, which is responsible for buying Maithili. Maithili Kraya Dhanam. If you are, Dhanam is the wealth that is Maithili, that is Sita. If I have to buy her, I have to, this Dhanus, this Shiva Dhanus is my the fees that I have to give for getting Maithili. Krayadhanam is more like a price that I have to pay for Maitri. Let that dhanus avirastu, let that bow come here, appear before me. This, to say that it is Shiva dhanus, he says, yat parvati hata kacha grahana praveene paanau sthitam, purabidaha paanau sthitam. Yat dhanuho, that bow which was sthitam, which was present in the hands of purabidaha paanau, not in the hands of, in one hand of Shiva. In, it was just present in one hand. Paanau purabhidaha tripurahara shivasya ekasmin paanau yat dhanuhu sthitam. That paani is actually praveena. It is an expert in handling Parvati's tresses, in Parvati's locks of hair. Parvati kachagrahane hatat kachagrahane, hatat by force or by surprise. He can quickly catch hold of her hair. It is an expert in doing that. In when he wants to show his love, Shiva is very capable of quickly catching hold of Shiva Parvati's hair. Or kachagrahana praveene can also mean to untie her hair. That he is also an expert in that. Not he is expert, his hand is expert. Tathavida paano sthitam yat dhanuho. For a long time it was there in his hand. Charadam sahasram sthitam. It was there for a long time. And then it is supposed to have been made by Vishwakarma using the essence of all the devas. Girvana sarakana nirmita gatram. Its gatram, its shariram, that is the dhanus shariram, was made using the girvana sara, deva sara, kana. All the small aspects of every deva was taken by Vishwakarma, and this the body of this bow was made. Tathavidam dhanuhu maithili kraya dhanam dhanuhu tat maithili kraya dhanam dhanuhu avirastu, let it appear in front of me. Now avirastu samam agarbha sambhavya sitaya, so let that dhanu also, this is Janaka's statement. Immediately he says, agarbha sambhavaya sitaya samam, along with the Sita, who was not born from the garbha of a lady. She was born from the earth, right? So, agarbha sambhavaya sitaya samam, avirastu, let it appear in front of us. When Janaka says this, see, it seems as if he wants to present the bow and Sita to Ravana. That is not proper here. Janaka will never say such a statement. Right? The connection of those statements are in such a manner. In Uttaramacharitam, if you see, Rama says, Mastu virahaha. Let there not be any viraha. And when the Pratihari comes and says, Deva upasthitaha, it adds to the Karuna Rasam or the Vipralamba Shungara that is there in the entire text. So it is an auchityam there, where it is not that Rama wants that viraha, but that viraha has come there despite Rama's wishes. That is the Prabandartha auchityam there. Okay. Whereas here, if you say Dhanuhu Avirastu and Janaka says, let that bow appear along with Sita, it means he is willing to give Sita to this Ravana. The way Kshemendra describes the anauchityam is even more beautiful. Atra avirastu samam sitaya iti janakarajena yatu uchyate. The words that Janaka says, tena, because of those words, asya pishitashanaya, pishitashanaya, pishita is mamsa, mamsa bhakshi. Mamsa bhakshi is pishitashanaha, Ravanaha. So, Mamsha Bhakshaya Ravanaya Tanaya Pratipadanam, he wants to give her his daughter. Abhimatam Iva Upalakshyate. It seems as if he is willing to give his daughter to her, which is not right. Janaka would not have said that. Nacha Etad Vidmaha. Don't we know that Katham Bhakshyabhutaha Kusuma Komalangi Purushada Purushadaya Purusham Atti Iti Purushadaha Purushadaya Rakshasaya. Bhakshyabhuta, how can such a Kusuma Komalangi, a lady who has such soft anga like flowers, how can she be Bhakshyabhuta? How can she be described as someone who is to be eaten, right? That doesn't fit there. Iti anauchityena prasiddham vritta vaiparityam param hridaya visamvadam adadati. The problem here is prasiddham vritta vaiparityam. That the vrittam is the story that had happened in Ramayana, or the story that also is described in Ramayanam. That is vrittam, the story. Vrittanta vaiparityam. It is not in accordance. It is different from what is being described there. Hence, what happens is param hridaya visamvadam adadati. It visamvadam is unpleasantness in the mind is created because of this, right? That he is offering such a beautiful, soft lady for a rakshasa. It creates an unpleasantness in the mind. Hence, there is prabandhartha anauchityam. It doesn't fit with the tone of the entire text. Okay, there is another example that he says in the text as such, which is from Kalidasa's Kumarasambhava. Are you okay? Can I just finish with this? Then the anauchityam part will be done. Okay, so yathava Kalidasasya, in the Ashtama Sarga, he gives a shloka. I'll give a small explanation of this because this is not there in the material. Uru moola nakha marga pankti bihi takshanam hrita vilochano haraha vasasaha prashithilasya samyamam kuruvatim priyatamam avarayat. I don't agree with the anauchityam, but still I will just explain what is there given by Kshemendra. This is in the 8th sarga of Kumarasambhava, where it describes the sport, the union between Shiva and Parvati after the marriage. The first time he describes the entire sarga like a nayaka and a nayaka, how they will behave. A lot of things are described in that manner. So here, Parvati, in the morning, she is trying to cover herself with her cloth. But Shiva is stopping her. Haraha, prashithilasya vasasaha samyamam kurvatim priyatamam avarayat. Avarayat, he stopped her. Haraha, Shiva stops Parvati from controlling or samyamam, vasasaha samyamam. She is putting her clothes properly on herself, and he is stopping her because he wants to enjoy with Parvati more. Right? So, kurvatim priyatamam avarayat. Prashithilasya vasasaha. It is abde nalvardhim bolya. It's slipping away. Tatha vidam prashithilasya vastrasya samyamam kurvatim parvatim priyatamam. Doesn't say Parvati here. Priyatama, she is his beloved, her Priya, her Naika, right? So he stops her from doing that. The adjective he gives why he stops is Takshanam. At that point of time, Shiva's eyes are attracted to the marks that are there on her thigh. So Uru Moola Nakha Marga Pankti Bihi. There are rows of Nakha Marga, the marks from the nakha on her uru moola, on her thighs, which are very beautiful for him. So he is hrita vilochanaha. All three eyes are attracted towards the beauty of her thigh. In fact, the beauty of her thigh will be described beautifully in the first sarga. That is an auchityam. Nagendra hastas tvachi karkashatvat upamana bahyaha. Even Brahma did not, people who want to describe her thighs don't know how to describe it. Nagendra hastaha. If I want to describe her thighs as, you know, the trunk of an elephant, tvachi karkashatvatu, it is so rough on the outside. If I have to describe it as, you know, vaala thandu, adhaadu bananas stalk, that is too cold. Kadali visheshaha shaityat. Ekanta shaityat kadali visheshaha. None of these objects in this world can even compare to her anga. And so he says upamana bahya, the her the, I have to exclude all the standard of comparison. Why do we compare a face to Chandra? Chandra is so beautiful because the moon is like one standard of comparison. The Kamalam or the lotus is like a standard of comparison. Whereas even if I search, I am not able to find a standard of comparison. That's how he views her and appreciates the beauty of her. He says, Uru Moola Naka Marga Pankti Vihi Hrita Vilochana. Shiva is attracted by her beauty and he wants to enjoy with her more. So he says, don't cover yourself. Vasasaha Prashitilasya Vasasaha Samyamam Kuruvatim Priyatamam Avarayat. He stops her. The problem here is, it is the opinion about this 8th Sarga itself is divided among historians, where they say it is inappropriate and Kshemendra falls under that category. There are people who say it is a Kavyam and my Nayaka is Shiva and Nayika is Parvati. More than that, it is the beauty of how they appreciated each other is absolutely necessary for life. That is how you can also lead your life. That is one set of people who believe in that. So here we will talk of how Kshemendra says it's an Auchityam. Atra Ambika Sambhoga Varnane. Because the Devi is described as having Sambhoga union. Pamaranari Samuchita. She's being described as a very regular woman who is a Naika. Nirlajja. Without any lajja, hri, or shame. Sajja, she is ready. At the same time, Nakaraji Virajita, she also has the nail marks of her husband, Uru Moola, and Shiva is being attracted by seeing this. And all these descriptions, Trilochanatvam, Trilochanasya Bhagavataha, even Shiva's attraction also, is yet uktam tena anauchityam. So it is not correct. That's what he says. So how is Shiva? He is Bhagavataha, he is a Bhagavan. Is Deva Tri Jagat Guru. He is like the guru or the father for the entire world. People say it is like, you know, talking of the union between father and mother. But it is an inevitable fact. That is another side to it that can also be argued. So Tena Anochityam Eva Param Prabandhasya Prabandartaha Pushnati Anochityam Pushnati. So this entire sarga, he says, only is not appropriate to the text, the entire text. So it gives an anauchityam to the prabandha. Okay, so with this we have finished the prabandhartha also, auchityam and anauchityam. Next is guna.